Watcher, this is a hashtag Summer of Singing workshop, and this is a deep dive into Carole King's You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman. And what we are doing is we are looking at, we are listening to, we are hearing, we are thinking how Carole brings soul to her performance, soul to the song. I'm not talking about soul music, that is a whole other workshop. I am talking about singing with authenticity, bringing truth to the song through our feelings, bringing the feels to the audience. So let's roll titles and get going. You make me feel like a natural woman. You may be more used to the Aretha Franklin version, but Carole King wrote the song. Carole King wrote loads of songs. She wrote The Locomotion, Kylie fans. I know, I thought it was Kylie when it came out in 1989. Everybody's doing a brand new dance now. But we are not talking about The Locomotion today. We are talking about You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman. And even if you are not a woman, you don't identify as a woman, you are a man or identify as someone else, you can still sing this song with the feels. We can still bring the action to this song because God, it's a good song. It really, really is. It's got everything. It's got the melody. It's got the lyrics. It's got the feels. And that's what I wanted to talk about in this workshop. How she brings the feels, how you can bring the feels to your singing. In the last workshop, we spoke about becoming a character to protect ourselves from maybe criticism or stage fright or just, you know, being a little bit afraid of putting ourselves out there. And we talked about, yeah, becoming a character like Beyoncé does. She becomes Sasha Fierce every time that she sings, every time that she performs on stage. And you may be thinking, hey, Alice, how can we be authentic in our singing and yet still be this character that protects us, that is our shield? Well, we can. We just need to bring a teeny weeny tiny bit of vulnerability to our performance, just a tiny bit, still not necessarily being our whole selves. Remember, again going back to our previous workshop, hey, if you haven't seen it, I'll link it at the end of this video and watch it. It was a very, very good workshop using Hamilton's You'll Be Back as kind of a springboard to discuss bringing drama and character and being a character when we sing, that isn't our whole selves, but is just a tiny, tiny fraction of ourselves. And that is the key. It's still ourselves. We still are our authentic selves, and we are this character. We're just one part of it. We are multifaceted beings, and singing and our singing character, our singing persona, is just one little teeny weeny tiny part of our performance, of ourselves. So yeah, we can still be authentic and still be vulnerable, open, and yet truth to ourselves. Because ultimately, when we're performing, we need to connect with the audience, and the audience need to see something in ourselves that they can relate to. That's why you got so many love songs and heartbreak songs and, you know, songs about stages of life that pretty much everybody goes through. Because no matter what your background, no matter where you come from, there are things that can unite us. Football is something that that unites the world. It's played so many, and just sport in general, obviously, it's played everywhere, and you can usually find common ground with that. There are some that don't like it though. Hey, cool. There are some that don't even like music. Yeah, there are. And it's weird, but there are. But my point is that things like growing up, heartbreak, losing a parent, first love, things like that, school, tend to be universal, tend to be things that everyone can relate to. And so if you're singing about that subject, your audience is going, yeah, I'm there, I feel you, I get that, I know that. But you have to be authentic with it. You can't say, I loved him and he broke my heart. I loved them, they destroyed me. You gotta feel it. I loved him and he broke my heart. I love them. They destroyed me. Get it in your eyes, feel it in your being. But we're going to listen to Carole King, You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman, to hear how we can put our soul, put our beings, put the feels into our singing. So let's listen in. Carole, I set you upright. Where are you gone? Before the day I met you. There she is. Don't you just love technology? And don't you just love live recordings? Don't you just love joking too? But I am a professional. I'm a total professional. And I'm going to take this moment as well, as I am choking, to talk about my professionalism and talk about the club. Because that's why I do all this, is to have everyone singing. That's my mission in life, is to, oh my goodness, this is going to go on all video. My mission in life is to have everyone singing, because singing is the most incredible thing. Singing sets you free. You don't necessarily, your goal needn't to be singing on stage or just even singing in front of anybody. It could just be to grow your voice so that you can give that speech in school, so that you can stand up in that meeting, because the skills that we learn through singing, through our singing lessons and building our voice, we can translate through to our daily lives, because, yeah, confidence just breeds confidence. It's fantastic. So, yeah, www.musicformy.co.uk. Head there, learn about our singing club. It's only £18 a month and you get a live singing session every single week, which is the same experience as a singing lesson, but for a fraction of the price. There's also our online library of video warm-ups and exercises, exclusive backing tracks as well. And we are singing You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman in Singing Club at the moment. What's not to love? www.musicformy.co.uk. Also, do the YouTubey things while you're here. If you're enjoying this video, like, subscribe, follow, all of that jazz. Recommend it to friends. Send up one of those, you know, planes with an advert going, woo, yay, Music for My. It would really, really help. Thank you. But yeah, let's get back to Carole King and we will hear her properly. Looking out on the morning rain. I used to feel uninspired. So what I'm going to talk about immediately, for how she's bringing the feels, is tailing off really, really dramatically at the end of every single phrase. Looking out on the morning rain. And then she goes, I used to feel uninspired. Goes into that uninspired. And you can kind of hear, because of the way she's singing, it's quite ploddy. Quite like, It's very down. And it is, it's like looking out on the morning rain, I used to feel uninspired. And so she's singing it that way. She's singing it like she is uninspired. She's really, really singing these lyrics through. It's all the feels.
And when I knew I'd have to face another day.
I love that swoop with new.
Lord, it made me feel so
again, tailing off with tired, and she goes, the Lord, it made me feel so tired. Lord, real emphasis of that word with that kind of that hairpin, crescendo, diminuendo, and that kind of Lord, moving up through the notes as well. It's this song, as we hear as we'll go on, it is... Structurally, it's just two verses and choruses, but and then a bridge. So quite traditional in that sense. But she sings it as if it's through composed. What do I mean by through composed? Through composed is telling a story through the music. So you're constantly changing. It's not a typical structure. Okay, so not like verse, chorus, bridge, chorus, or in a classical sense, not in certain movements or anything like that, not in any kind of structure, just makes it up as it goes along. Basically, that's through composed. It's like, oh, okay, you're going to do that bit there. Oh, okay, you're going to do that bit there. Oh, you can change it up there. Oh, all right, okay, yeah, great. Yeah, kind of. I mean, technically this isn't properly, but she mixes it up. She plays with the melody, plays with the emphasis of the phrasing, plays a little bit with the rhythm as well. All of these elements, all of these things bring soul. So what have we had? We've had her tailing off at the end of her phrases. We've had her really doing like hairpins on words like Lord, Lord. So already we've had lots of soul, lots of feels. All about bringing the feels.
Before the day I met you.
You.
Life was so unkind.
Kind. Off for the natural woman. So the sentence is, the song is written, you make me feel like a natural woman. And she tails off with the natural woman part. That's it's so reflective. You make me feel like a natural woman, like happy, basically. You make me feel happy. You make me feel content. Raspiness in her voice as well. Can you hear that? It's really subtle. It's gorgeous. This is her her style, her natural voice, and she's not fighting it at all. She's not. It's not looking for pure tone, beautiful. It is beautiful, but like a kind of like a classically pure tone. She's not looking for that at all. She's allowing the raspiness to come through, which again brings the feels. Things like we've talked about ugly singing in previous workshops. It's all about bringing the feels, and that's what it does when you have that raw moment, when your voice cracks, when it breaks. It's a moment of beauty. It's a moment of passion. It's not a negative. So stop thinking that things have to be perfect. No. I really think, especially in contemporary singing and pop singing, but also, yeah, to a certain extent, musical theatre, because if you're performing, if you're in the moment, especially if it's like, oh my gosh, a really, really dramatic song. And the one that comes to mind immediately is Evita, and when she's dying and she's singing her lament, and you want, you know, you want that passion to come through, and that kind of, that break. But also in Les Mis, I Dreamed a Dream. Have you seen the film with Anne Hathaway's performance? It's so raw. And she won an Oscar for it, because it brought the feels. And she was acting, you know? She's playing a part. And yet she was genuine with that acting. Do you see that? Do you see how there's this line, there's this fine line between overacting and kind of being a bit fake, and then allowing that percentage, and it's a small percentage of yourself, into your performance that makes it real, that makes it authentic. A lot of it is about being present, being truly in the moment. And I know that these days it's so hard to be present, because we have all of our worries going over in our head, all our anxieties, pressures from the outside world. We're constantly being bombarded. We're even constantly being bombarded with the pressure to be mindful and to be present, which in itself is a stress. But simple things that you can do that might, you know, that work for me, that might work for you: body tapping, just tuning yourself in to the moment, focusing on certain things. So I'm going to focus on my brand of screen that I'm staring at right now. I'm going to look at every single letter. It's a 7-letter word, and I'm just going to focus in on that. That, if you focus on things that are external to you, that'll bring you to the present, as will what I do in warm-ups, you know, when we're grounding ourselves and we're feeling the ground beneath our feet and doing body scans, full body scans, but also our breathing in for 5, holding for 5, and breathing out for 15. That is a mindfulness exercise that will bring us to the present, make us present. That's what mindfulness is. And it's when your mind wanders to your shopping list, or, oh gosh, I didn't do that today. You know, things that you've forgotten, worries that you might have. That's when you lose the authenticity. Bring the moment. Be in the moment. Be in the song. So just listen to the words, sing the words, feel the words. That'll help you.
Oh, when my soul was in the lost and found.
So second verse.
You came along to claim it.
I love how she does that. You came along to claim it. Subtle again, because there are so many subtleties in her voice, but can you hear it's a little bit more, it's happier now, it's much more kind of more positive. You came along to claim it. I can hear a smile in her voice. And remember, I've said in previous workshops again that it's proven customer service phone people, it's proven that the customer can hear the smile and the happy disposition. I'm so sorry, we're going to have to charge you £300 extra on your bill this month. They can hear that, and we can hear that she's smiling, you know, she's feeling that. You came along to claim it. You were there for me. I said in our club session, exclusive music for my club singing session on Monday, that this doesn't necessarily need to be about someone. This could be about a pet. This could be about a thing that you love, like a favorite song coming along and claiming it. And your favorite song is making you feel like a natural woman or an actual person, an actual being, you know, you're making you happy. Don't necessarily take the lyrics so literally. They are Carole King's lyrics. They mean what they mean to her. They don't necessarily mean what they mean to you. And they can mean different things to you. And that is valid in your performance. We only have to look at recently, it's been popularized because Sinead O'Connor tragically died very recently, only a few weeks ago. And her cover of Prince's Nothing Compares to You was doing the rounds. That's because that's her most favorite song. That's a cover of a song which meant completely different things to Prince as it did to Sinead. You must have seen the video where she's there and she's crying, and that was a genuine moment in that video. They didn't say to her, cry on cue now, cry, cry, cry. No, no, she felt it. She felt the song. The emotion took over and she just wept as she sang. That was genuine. That were the feels. That was soul. She put her soul into that performance. I wouldn't say that Sinead O'Connor is a soul singer, but she has soul. Of course she does. We all have soul. And it went into that performance in a way that made it a bigger song than Prince's original. In fact, yeah, definitely. Everyone thinks Nothing Compares to You. I think the vast majority of people think, oh, that's Sinead O'Connor's song, rather than it being a Prince song. So, yeah. This is my point. You can make a song truly your own. You can take different meaning from your song. You can take different meaning from the lyrics. Whatever it is that's going to help you bring the feels. That's what it's all about.
I didn't know just what was wrong with me till your kiss helped me name it.
Oh, I love that. It's all staccato or broken.
Till your kiss. Of what I'm living for. Cause if I make you happy, I don't need to do more. You make me feel.
Can you hear that raspiness? Raspiness also for the woman, going up into her nasal resonance. She's also very like kind of a, like, now I'm no longer doubtful, going back into her throat, bringing different color to her voice, playing with color. Not just one colour either, because we go up and down and we go on a journey with songs. So like I said at the beginning, a little bit kind of maybe darker, a little bit, not down, but a little bit, just a little bit, because she was like, oh, you know, it's raining and blah, 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 blah. And now she's like getting a little bit more positive and there's richer colour coming through because she's got throatiness, but she still has her raspiness. All of this is bringing the feels. All of this is bringing soul. And now we have the bridge and then the breakdown, which just make the song. The way she sings You Make Me Feel So Good Inside, it's very, well, she's playing against the rhythm and it's like she's walking through sludge, or she's at Glastonbury Festival when it has just been raining for 2-3 days and then the sun comes out, so it makes that mud just, if you know, It's like walking through treacle and you lose your wellies every step you take, and it's just like, it's almost like slow motion. You make me feel so good inside. I'm exaggerating for effect, but because she's doing that, you're feeling with her, you know, you make me feel so good inside. She could have just gone, you make me feel so good inside. You make me feel so good inside. You know, she could have changed it. The fact that she elongated that phrase to the full, however many bars she wanted it to be, brings emphasis, brings strength to that, like, you make me feel so good inside. And that's what the whole song is about. It's about feeling good. You make me feel like an actual woman. You make me feel good. Oh, love it, love it, love it. Close to you comes in ahead of when we're expecting it. So the more important line, because you're like talking by surprise, like, oh, okay, close to you. You make me feel so alive. I would argue that that's the more important line because, yeah, she feels alive. This song, I kind of, the more I listen to it, I'm like, yeah, this is a song about her, how she is, not about the person. Yes, the person has an effect on her, but it's her. It's her. Make me feel. Can you hear that? She's singing the F. Normally with consonants, with our singing, we're getting to the vowel and we're getting off consonants as quickly as possible because the consonants are the things that chop the sound off and don't sound pretty, especially when you are on a microphone or apologies for that, but you know what I mean. Those are the things that are kind of no-nos in certain aspects of singing, but this is what she's doing. She's bringing the feels. You. She even does the you. She lengthens the yeah moment and all the wonderful diphthongs that we have in the English language. Diphthongs are when you have two vowel sounds to one word, one vowel. So I is the most common example that I use, an I in English is IE, IE vowel. So that's a diphthong. They're really annoying to sing, really annoying. But anyway, she in this song loves it. You. So you kind of just going you make me feel. Feel with you, Carol. I do. Can you, like, you know, if you're singing this breakdown, and the wonderful thing about breakdowns in any song, codas at the end, you know, when you're just riffing, doing whatever, you can change it, you can mix it up every single night, you can add, especially things like this, you can bring in, you can come in early, bring in an extra thing, you can go up higher, you can go low, you make me feel, you know, you can just totally play with it, and I would encourage you to play with it, make it your song, make it your own song. Just be genuine with it. Just really feel yourself. I mean, you're talking about feeling in this song. Feel it yourself. Feel it yourself. The audience will feel it. That's soul in singing. That's what it is. That's authentic singing. You make me feel. You make me feel. You make me feel.
natural woman.
And I just, that ending, she could have finished, she could have chosen to finish the song on a big massive, on the big power. You make me feel like a natural woman, a natural woman. But she finishes it in a reflective way. Natural woman. Because she's content, she's happy, she's there. Such a good song. Such a good song. So good. Listen to that. Listen to other Carole King songs. Listen to the Aretha Franklin version as well. But think about when you are singing this, think about something that makes you happy. As I said, whether it's your pet, whether it's your favorite song, your favorite jumper, your favorite toy, honestly, anything. Your mum, your dad, your brother, your sister, whatever. Think about that when you are singing this song, the feelings that you are having, while also being present with the words, maybe manipulating the words slightly so that they fit whatever it is that makes you feel happy, that makes you feel like a natural being, you feel content. And that is going to bring soul to your performance. It's not rogic. It's not rocket science. It does take a little bit of practice, as everything does. Grab a mirror so you can look at it and see it in your eyes. See what your audience is seeing. See the communication that you are giving as the performer to your audience. Remember, it is a two-way thing, very much two-way thing. It's reciprocal. Music, it's weird. It doesn't really exist. It exists in the people listening to it. That's so deep. Maybe that's another workshop for a later date. But there we go. That was a deep dive into You Make Me Feel Like a Natural Woman by Carole King. Looking at how we can bring soul, we can bring authenticity to our performances. You've made it to the end of the video, so please like and subscribe and follow and do all the YouTubey things, because it would really, really help. Also, head to musicformy.co.uk, learn about our singing club, maybe think about joining our singing club. It's only £18 a month. But otherwise, I will see and sing with you next time. Bye.